Greetings, viewers and subscribers. So in today's journey, we are going to continue where we left off yesterday. We are going to be leaving the parish of Manchester and we are going to enter the parish of Clarendon. Remember, we are on our way to Kingston. Sit back, relax, grab a bottle of your favorite beverage and drive with me. Now, like we told you this morning, this is our second video for today. Later on, we'll be uploading a third video. That will be our second trip to the Negril craft market. Stand by for that one. In this video, like we promised, we are gonna give you a roundup of crimes and incidents that took place in Western Jamaica between Friday the 23rd and Saturday the 24th of July 2021. Now, first up, this incident, it took place along the Bamboo Main Road in the Sandy Bay Police Area in the parish of Hanover. It took place last night, Saturday, the 24th of July, 2021, about 9:30 p.m. Our information is that a man, his name is Mr. Malik Binns. He's popularly known as Nash. He's 25 years old. And he is a landscaper. He lives at Bamboo District in Hanover. Nash, he was riding a green Jamco motorcycle. He was on his way home when our information is that he lost control of the motorcycle. As a result, the motorcycle crashed into a wall on the right side of the road and ended up in an open trench. Nash, he was assisted by family members to the Cornwall Regional Hospital, where Nash, he was pronounced dead on arrival at the hospital. Sad, sad indeed. May his soul rest in peace and condolences to his family. In the next incident, now from the other day, we have been carrying some stories about firearms being recovered at retirement in the Granville Police Area in the parish of St. James. We also carried a story where four persons, two males and two females, were arrested by the Hanover police at a place named Blenheim in the Kingsville Police Area. Those four persons are from retirement in St. James. Now, this incident, it also took place at retirement in St. James. It took place on Friday, the 23rd of July 2021, about 7 a.m. Now, our information is that a joint police and military patrol. Now, let me pause for a moment. I need to explain something. In our video on Friday, we told you that whenever the soldiers are patrolling, you normally see police officers with them, because a soldier do not have the power of arrest that a police have. One of our viewers, or one of our subscribers, he was wondering if it means that if no police was present, the soldier would have to let go the man who he found with the gun. We like addressing these topics because he asked the question, and I am sure a lot of other persons might have had the same question. Let me explain it. When I say the soldiers don't have the same powers of arrest like what a police officer has, it means this. As civilians, we all have powers of arrest. It is the same powers of arrest that a soldier have. So you or I, or a soldier, can see somebody committing a crime. We can arrest the person, because as long as you restrain somebody's movement, you detain somebody, it means you have arrested them. So we can arrest that person and we can take the person to the police station and hand them over to the police. The police will then arrest and charge the person. So a soldier, see somebody committing a crime, they can arrest the person, but they cannot charge the person. They will have to take the person to a police to charge the person. So back on track, like we were saying, this one took place at retirement, Friday the 23rd of July 2021, about 7 o'clock in the morning, a joint police military patrol. They were on an operation in the retirement area. We are told that an open lot was searched. During the search, one shotgun was found wrapped in a black and white plastic bag. It was found hidden under some stones. The firearm was seized, but no one was arrested in this find. Congratulations to the Montego Bay Police for acting speedily and recovering this weapon. In the next story, now, this one, it took place at Anchovy Square. Anchovy is in the parish of St. James. It took place Friday night, the 23rd of July, 2021, about 7:30. Now, our information is that a man, his first name is Damian. He's 31 years old and he lives at a place named Roampton. Damian, it is said that he was walking along the roadway when a group of men were traveling in a motor car. The men, on seeing Damian, they stopped and two of them alighted from the car. At least one of the men, it is reported, was armed with a gun. Our information is that they wanted to kidnap Damian. They didn't want to fire any shots right in the Anchovy Square. For whatever reason, you know, the police station is right up there. So, Damian, on seeing the men, he ran off. The men chased him and caught up with him. And one of the men, who is known to him as Kemar, he used a knife to stab Damian in his left shoulder. Damian managed to run and escaped his attackers. By this time, a crowd had converged. So the men, they ran back to the car that they came out of and made good their escape in the said motor car in the area. Damian, he was transported to a nearby hospital by the police, where he was admitted in a serious condition. At the time of doing this video, we hadn't gotten any information as to the status of Damian. But if anything changed, you know, we'll be updating this story. Now, if you are here, if you are watching the videos, if you have not yet hit on the like button, remember to hit on it. If you have not yet subscribed, hit on the subscribe button. We are now over 22,000 subscribers. I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for sharing our videos. Thank you for telling a friend to tell a friend. Blessings to you. Blessed love. Now, this one, it took place broad daylight. It took place at Rose Heights. It took place on Friday, the 23rd of July, 2021, about 11 a.m. Like we say, broad daylight. Our information is that a group of persons, they were at a party being held at Rose Heights, when our information is that several loud explosions were heard. These loud explosions sounded like gunshots. The patrons were at the party. They started running in different directions. At the end of the shooting, three persons who were at the party, they received gunshot wounds. A man, he's called Shafai, he was on his way to a shop. He wasn't in at the party. He was also shot. The four persons shot, they were rushed to a nearby hospital where all of them were admitted. Now, Shafai, he received a gunshot wound to his right hand. One of the men who were at the party, he's popularly called Braff, he received gunshot wounds to his left side. Another man who was at the party, his name is Neville, and Neville is 56 years old. He received gunshot wounds to the left side of his chest. Those three persons, our information is that their injuries are not considered life-threatening. But another man who was at the party, he's known as Stefan. He also received a gunshot wound to the left side of his chest. Our information is that Stefan, he's in a very serious condition. When we were recording this video, we hadn't gotten any update as to the status of Stefan. But we are told that based on his injuries, he has a 50-50 chance. Now, this crime scene was processed by the police, and our information is that a number of 9mm spent shells were found. But also found was one Browning 9mm pistol. This 9mm pistol was affixed with a magazine with 6 9mm rounds in it. This 9mm pistol was found behind a ply board at the location. Now, in the final story for today, this one, it took place at Whitehall. Now, at Whitehall, there's a place that they call Little Haiti. Yes, Whitehall in the grill I'm talking about. There's a place that they call Little Haiti. Over the past few months, there have been a lot of shootings in that area, Little Haiti, in Negril, in the parish of Westmoreland. This latest incident, it took place at Little Haiti, Whitehall in Negril, in the parish of Westmoreland. It took place last night, Saturday, the 24th of July, 2021. Now, we are told that residents of Little Haiti, they reported hearing loud explosions sounding like gunshots. As a result, the police were called in. On the arrival of the police, two men were found suffering from gunshot wounds. One of the men, he has been identified as Junior Williams. He was 41 years old and he lived at Little Haiti. The other man, so far, our information is that he has been unidentified. Well, at the time we're doing this video, we haven't gotten his name because he was yet to be identified. If and when we get his name, we'll be updating this video. But on the arrival of the police, both men were found suffering from gunshot wounds. They were found in a yard at Little Haiti, Whitehall, Negril, in the parish of Westmoreland. The police took both men to the Savlamar Hospital, where they were pronounced dead. Junior Williams, he received gunshot wounds to the back of his head and the right side of his face. The other man, who is yet to be identified, he received gunshot wounds to the right side of his face. Our information is that when the police processed this crime scene, 8 9mm spent shells were recovered from the scene. The mayhem continues. Blessed love, everybody.